the quadratic formula. Our goal is to use the quadratic formula to solve quadratic equations and also to verify those solutions graphically when possible. The quadratic formula. The solutions of any quadratic equation, ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a does not equal 0, are given by x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. The formula is not magic. It's been derived by completing the square on the equation ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. This is shown in a different video. Graphically, the zeros of a quadratic function occur where y or f of x is equal to 0. If the zeros of a quadratic function are real, they will be the x-intercepts of the parabola. Recall that to find x-intercepts, you set y equal to 0. So there's a connection between the x-intercepts and the solutions to quadratic equations, and here it is. If you are given f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c, and you set f of x equal to 0, you would have, basically, a quadratic equation set equal to 0. So the solutions to this quadratic equation will also be the x-intercepts as long as they are real values. Let's take a look at an example. We want to solve negative x squared plus 3x plus 10 equal to 0. Check the solution graphically. This is factorable, but we are going to solve this using the quadratic formula. First thing we need to do is identify the values of a, b, and c. A is equal to the coefficient of x squared. B is equal to the coefficient of x. And c is equal to the constant 10. We're going to do the substitution into the formula and then begin to simplify. B squared would be 3 squared. I'm not doing any math this time, I'm just doing the substitution. Now let's begin to simplify. Let's come back to the square root. Okay, the number underneath the square root is called the discriminant. Let's see if we can figure out what that's going to be. 3 squared, of course, would be 9. We'd have 9 minus a negative 40. So that would become 9 plus 40, or 49. And it happens that 49 is a perfect square, so this becomes negative 3 plus or minus 7 divided by negative 2. So we have two solutions. The first solution, x equals negative 3 plus 7 divided by negative 2. That would give us a value of negative 2. And our second solution, x equals negative 10 divided by negative 2, which is equal to 5. So our solutions to this quadratic equation are x equals negative 2 and x equals 5. Now graphically, if we let f of x equal this quadratic, negative 2 and positive 5 should be our x-intercepts. Let's verify that. To save some time, I've already typed in the quadratic equation into y1. Take a look at the graph, and this does verify our work. We have an x-intercept here of negative 2 and an x-intercept of positive 5. I could also check the table to make sure that when x is 5, I have a y value of 0, and when x is negative 2, I have a y value of 0. Our work is done correctly. Let's try one more. Solve 2x squared minus 4x minus 3 equals 0. Check your answer graphically on the graphing calculator. Okay, we're going to go ahead and identify our values for a, b, and c. A equals 2, b equals negative 4, c equals negative 3. Again, the first step, I'm just going to do the substitution. All over 2 times a. And again, start simplifying. Okay, so negative 4 become positive 4 plus. Let's come back to the discriminant. Our denominator is also 4. Okay, on this one, we're going to have negative 4 squared, which is positive 16, minus a negative 24, which becomes plus 24. So 16 plus 24 would give us 40. we need to simplify this square root. Now remember 40, I could write 40 as 4 times 10, and the square root of 4 would be 2. So this would become 4 plus 2 square root 10 divided by 4. Now it's very tempting to simplify these two 4s, but that would be incorrect. I always like to take the extra step and write this as two separate fractions to simplify it. 4 over 4 plus or minus 2 square root 10 over 4, and simplify them individually. This will eliminate any careless simplifying mistakes. 4 over 4 will give us 1, plus or minus 2 over 4, of course, simplified to 1 half, so square root of 10 divided by 2. So our solutions, x equals 1 plus the square root of 10 divided by 2, and x equals 1 minus square root of 10 divided by 2. Now, it'd be very difficult to try to verify these values as x-intercepts because they're irrational. So I've already taken the time to convert them into a decimal. And this would be approximately 2.58. And this would be approximately negative 0.58. These are the values we will look to see if these are our x-intercepts. Let's go back to the graphing calculator. Okay, I already have the function typed into y2. So what I'm going to do is go over to the equal sign on the first function that we just used, hit enter to turn it off, and hit enter on y2 to turn it back on, and I'm going to graph it. It does look like this is somewhere between negative 1 and 0, maybe negative 0.58, and this one is between 2 and 3, again, a good sign. Let's just go ahead and verify one of them more specifically. If I hit second trace, brings up the calculation menu, and I can find the 0, and I can find one of the zeros. It's going to ask me to go to the left side of one of the zeros. Let's verify the one on the right. I'm on the left side, I'm going to hit enter. I'm going to move to the right side of that 0, hit enter, and then enter again. And it looks like that it is correct. The 0 is 2.58 approximately, which is one of the values that we found. I'll leave the other verification to you. I hope it helps explain how to use the quadratic formula and how to verify it graphically when possible.